Yeah. Well, I think I said yesterday, you know, they've gotten exceptional goaltending all year. We're prepared, you know, for either guy. I know we're going to get a good game out of both guys, whoever it ends up being, and, you know, we've got to make sure we're ready for that. Nothing specific, you know. They've gotten good goaltending all year. They have the whole playoff series, and I expect the same tonight. What's that? It's a good question.
And you're going with your same guy, right? No change for you.
Same guy, George.
Look like the
good question.
All right, let's get out of here.
Look like the guys were loose this morning.
Yeah.
Like not too uptight or anything. Looking forward to it.
Yeah, you know what? Hey, this is what it's all about. You play all year for these situations. So I think we're ready. And guys are ready to go.
Pete, what's it like for you? You have a few game sevens in Kitchener, I imagine.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, over your coaching career, you get in these situations, you know, you got to embrace the moment. Again, like players, you've got to, this is what hockey's all about, you know, one game and either move on or you go home. So that's the type of pressure you like.
Mostly successful, I imagine, in Kitchener.
You know, hey, when you coach long enough, you have both ends. You know, look at Marty's, I think someone was showing me Marty's game seven record. You're playing enough of them, you're going to have, you know, great ones, and you're going to have results you don't like. But, you know, you wouldn't want to be anywhere else but in this situation.
Peter, some of the players, and there's a talk about how it's going to be hard to fall asleep for their pre-game matches and all that.
Yeah.
I'm sure your guys say the same. What's a game seven day like for a head coach?
Yeah. You know, a lot of waiting around. You know, I think when you play a team six times, the work's done at this point. You know, it's your team's prepared. It's just, you know, waiting around for the puck to drop and making sure that they're in the flow of the game. So, you know, we've done that. And, yeah, this is the painful part, you know, from now until game time.
Can you relax today at all?
No, probably not. No.
So you're glad you had that extra hour and a half or whatever it is.
You know what? No, I mean, I think everybody, both teams, both coaches, probably would like to play the game at noon here and get it on. You know, you get to this point, you want to get into it and get it going. So, you know, the waiting around isn't perfect, but both teams have to do it, and you deal with it.
Looks like Jason Garrison's back. What have the Panthers missed with him being out the last couple of games?
Yeah, key guy for him. You know, he's a you know, I mean, he helps them in, you know, all their areas. Defensively, he can play against the best players on the penalty kill, on the power play. So he's an important piece for them, and, you know, that'll definitely help them.
Pete, your fourth line really had an impact in this series. Can you just talk about how well
that played? Well, you know, I think that when we drew Florida, you know, Florida's been a four-line team all year and gotten contributions from the depth of their lineup. We felt that was going to be a key, that we were going to have to get, you know, some depth scoring and our third and fourth lines to really be involved in the series. And those guys have taken that challenge and run with it.
What have you seen from Clarkson so far this season?
You know what, I think Clarkie's on the verge of breaking out. I think he's played well. He's played his typical agitating game where he's been effective. He's made some plays, you know, rather than finish some off like he did during the regular season. But I think the goals are right there. I think it's just going to be a matter of time here.
Pete, the first 5 minutes, kind of critical that your team remains poised, knowing that everyone's going to be ramped up here in Florida.
Yeah, for sure. You know, I think if you look back to the games in the series, you know, where either team got a quick jump and put the other team in a hole. It was usually tough to climb out of, even though there were some blown leads. So I don't think anyone wants to get in a hole early here, and we'll be ready.
I would say, you know, game seven, your best player is always going to be your best player. So when it comes to a guy like Zach Parise, captain,
yeah.
What are your expectations for him tonight?
You know what, just bring the game Zach always brings. You know, he's the hardest working guy on the ice every night, and if he brings that, you know, good things follow him. So, you know, I don't have any expectations. I never with Zach on goals, assists, that stuff follows what he does best, and that's outwork people.
Did you watch the game last night?
I did, yeah.
Is that the kind of typical kind of game you're going to see in a game seven?
Yeah. I mean, low scoring, 2-1 game, overtime. You draw it up that way, but you never know with these things. You know, they can be all over the map. So we just want to make sure we're on the right end of it at the end of the night.